In this laptop, a huge amount of hidden balls. And this one, and this one. Disconnect those cables using the flat screwdriver. This is the touchpad and the mouse, both of them. The cover is almost removed. Disconnect this cable and this one. Put it away. Here you can see a huge amount of dust everywhere. Used alcohol based wipes to clean everything from there. And we can see the LVSD cable, which goes from LCD screen to the motherboard right there. Right now we have to disassemble the screen itself to take out LCD screen from it. The screen mounted on these bolts. And besides these bolts, there is also a huge amount of cables. The cables which are responsible for the wireless, LVSD cable, the modem. You have to disconnect all of those and then remove two screws right there and two screws right there. And you will be able to remove the screen out. Disconnect the LVSD cable. Remove this bolt. Remove those two bolts. Disconnect wireless antennas. Remove the tape which is attaching it. I couldn't remove this bolt. I used the proper screwdriver and I stripped the thread inside. This sometimes happens. That's why I will replace the screen while all these cables are connected right there. It's still possible. You have to remove these rubber covers and you have to remove those four bolts. 1, 2, 3, 4. Only four bolts. The long bolts was in the bottom and the short bolts was on top. Pop up the cover, completely remove it. Yes, it's possible to do it for sure. And plus, here all these LVSD cables which goes from LCD screen to the LVSD connector on the motherboard, they very properly secured and fitted. If once you will remove them, it's very hard to put them the same way how they was right there. That's why maybe it's more reasonable to do it this way. Maybe it's even better that I couldn't remove this bolt. Right now remove this bolt, this, this, and this to take this LCD screen out. When you removed the four bolts, this, 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 and this, you can lift it up and you can disconnect the hinges. This bolt, this, and these three bolts from one side and three bolts from the other side, and you will be able to remove the screen. But firstly disconnect this cable, because the new screen you will need to connect the new screen. Alright, LVSD cable is disconnected from here. The screen is on hinges. Remove three bolts. Six bolts are removed, which was attaching the screen. This is the replacement into the hinges. And disconnect the back light cover. The backlight. This is how it looks. The screen is removed. All these cables are intact, as I mentioned before, because I couldn't remove this bolt. Compare the broken screen with the replacement, especially all those connectors. They seem to be the same for me. The light for LCD connector is the same. Everything matches. install the new screen. Firstly secure on one bolt there, and another bolt on the other side. Then put more bolts. Be careful not to break the new screen. You secure the screen on the hinges. Connect the cable back on and the backlight. Put some additional tape. Luckily for me, the connector is absolutely identical. Sometimes they're different, and you have to get a new LVSD cable, which sometimes are very costly. Could cost you up to $50. Put the screen top cover back on. Put the screws. When the new screen is already installed, it's a good chance to clean everything from the dust. It's a huge amount of dust, clean everything. It's a huge amount of dust. We'll be using alcohol wipes to clean all this. Especially right there. And plus, this dust sometimes wet. This is number one, what kills your laptops. The dust, and especially in Florida, it's very humid. That's why all this dust deposits becoming wet. Right now it's totally clean. I sprayed it with alcohol-based liquid, vodka in this case, and right now I will let it dry for a couple of hours. It's not a regular water, that's why it will evaporate really very quickly. 4 hours and for sure evaporation will be completed. When you make sure that everything is totally dry, completely dry everywhere, it's time to start assembling everything back on. I wait for 12 hours to make sure that it's totally dry. There is no droplets, and plus I used alcohol liquid. It's not a water, it's alcohol liquid evaporate almost just right away. Apply some new thermal compound. I'm using IC Cara Diamond 7. GPU don't require, I just have this, like a pouch, right there. And those, they're supposed to be located like this. This one is on GPU, and some thermal compound right there. I recommend you using Arctic Silver 7 thermal compound. IC Karat Diamond 7. And install the heatsink back on. Tighten the bolts using the short bolts like this. Three of them right there and two of them right there. Install the RAM motors back on. Make sure that everything connected correctly. In case if you disconnected it before, to completely remove the screen, but in this case I do not recommend you, because sometimes it's very hard to properly allocate everything. Anyway, make sure that everything is well fitted and properly connected, and install the top cover. Connect those four cables. This one, be very gentle. This one, and this one. Then plug computer to the power source and give it a test try before you will install all screws and the keyboard back. We want to make sure that LCD using LVSD cable connected properly to the motherboard. Alright. Yes, everything is connected properly. Start assembling everything back on. The hard drive, DVD-ROM, insert the hard drive. Install the screw. Right. Start putting all the screws from the top. You have to put screw everywhere. You see an arrow. Right there, right there, over here, here, and here. Install the keyboard. Connect the keyboard back on. Allocate it back and just simply click it inside. Like this. Install all the screws back on, and as I mentioned before, the deepest screw that this laptop have, this one. Goes right there. Install all the screws back. DVD-ROM as well. All screws are installed, everything assembled back on. Connect the power. And turn the laptop on. This was the assembly and screen replacement on Sony Vaio 5G 3L. Thanks for watching.